So over the past 2 years or so, Amazon has seen a lot of success with the Amazon Fire TV Sticks. And just recently in October, they released the second generation of the TV Stick. So we're gonna check this thing out today, so stay tuned. So the Amazon Fire TV Stick is just that. It's a stick that you plug into the HDMI port on your TV, and it's gonna allow you to stream music and video. And it can essentially turn any TV into a smart TV. It's gonna come preloaded with apps like Hulu, Netflix, HBO Go, and of course Amazon Video, but it does have access to thousands of different apps, which is good for cord cutters or people who don't wanna pay for satellite or cable subscriptions. And even if there is an app that you can't find in the Amazon store, you can actually sideload apps onto it, and I'll show you how to do that in a little bit. So what's new with the new generation of the Fire Stick? Well, for starters, it's gonna come with a quad core processor. So a lot of people were complaining about the performance on the old Fire Stick, about it being a little slow, a little laggy. You're not really gonna have those problems with this one. I haven't really had any issues with it. It's noticeably faster. And now the stick has Alexa built into it, so you can just use the voice remote to talk to Alexa. You can tell her to play a certain song. You can tell her to play a certain movie on Netflix or something like that. Really cool. And the new Fire TV Stick also comes with wireless AC, which is plenty of speed for you to connect to the internet to download and stream movies. And it's listed at $39.99, which I personally think is an amazing price for what you're getting. Now, it does support up to 1080p or full HD, but it doesn't have support for 4K. In order to get 4K, you've got to jump up to the Fire TV box, which is actually still reasonably priced at 90 bucks. So the Fire TV Stick is really gonna be for three different types of people. The first group of people is gonna be cord cutters, or people who don't wanna pay for cable or satellite subscriptions. You just basically wanna do like local TV, and you wanna be able to stream movies and TV shows that you wanna watch. This works perfectly for that. Now, Amazon is clearly aiming the Fire TV and the Fire TV Stick at cord cutters. They even have a package with an HD antenna, because obviously if you don't have cable or satellite, you're gonna need an antenna. And nowadays, you can actually watch things like HBO and Showtime without actually having a cable subscription. You can just pay fees directly to them and stream them on their own apps. And the second type of person that's gonna use the Fire TV Stick is basically gonna be someone who wants a smart TV. So maybe you bought a cheaper TV or you have an older TV and it doesn't have smart features or apps on it. You're just gonna plug the Fire TV Stick into it and it's gonna magically turn your TV into a smart TV. And the third type of person is basically gonna be that person who wants to jailbreak it. You basically wanna install like an app like Kodi onto it, and you can install all kinds of third-party add-ons where you can get free TV and stuff like that. That's really huge with the Fire TV Stick and a bunch of other Android-based boxes. And installing third-party apps like Kodi onto the Fire TV Stick is really simple, and I'll show you how to do that in a little bit. All right, so this is gonna be your home screen. So this is what you're gonna see anytime you start up your Fire TV. You will see ads at the top, which is kind of one of the ways they keep down the cost for the Fire Stick, but it's easy to navigate. The interface is very similar to Android TV. Notice you don't see YouTube here. And that's because you have to actually install YouTube. All right, so I do want to show you the Fire TV app real quick. So if you launch this app, it's going to show your list of Fire TVs here. So once it connects, this is what you get. Now this is like a touchpad, so you can like swipe down to go down, and then you can tap on something to select it. So if you just tap, that's gonna select it, just like it did Netflix there. But my favorite part about the app is the fact that you have a keyboard here. So instead of you using the directional pad to slowly type something in, you can just type it in right there. So that's really nice. And you can actually still use the voice controls through that as well. Play Luke Cage on Netflix. All right, so it does look like that works. It doesn't bring it right up for you, but it looks like it just kind of shows you, is this what you mean? And you get the Alexa voice. That's pretty cool, not bad. So while I'm in here, I do actually want to show you how you install third-party apps, and it's really, really simple. So the first thing you're gonna do is go to settings, and you're gonna go to system. You're gonna scroll all the way down to developer options. You're gonna turn on ADB debugging, and you're gonna allow apps from unknown sources. Click OK. You're gonna go to About, go to Network, and now you see your IP address there. So we're gonna use that IP address to install Kodi onto the TV Stick. So from this point, everything else is gonna be done straight from your phone. So it's really gonna be super straightforward and easy to do. First thing you're gonna do is open up your browser. You're gonna go to Kodi.tv. All right, then you're gonna go to Download, Downloads right there. You're gonna keep scrolling down until you see current release. There it is, ARM. So you're gonna download the file. Then you're gonna go to the Play Store. You're gonna type in apps to Fire. There you go. So go ahead and install the apps to Fire app. Open that up, scroll over, go to setup. And here's where you're gonna put the IP address of your Fire. All right, so once you put in the IP address there, you're gonna hit save, and you're gonna hit this upload arrow here. So you're gonna hit that. Depending on where your downloads go when you download files, it's probably in download. So there's the APK. That's the APK we just downloaded. So wherever yours is, you gotta find it. Once you find it, tap on it, hit install, and that's it. All right, so the app says it is successful. Now you notice you see it says Kodi ready to launch. That means boom, it's installed it. And it did say install successful on the Apps to Fire app. So now that that's done, the very first thing we're gonna do before we forget is go down to developer options, and we're gonna turn these off. Now this is optional, but I definitely recommend you leave those off. There's Kodi. Go ahead and fire it up. All right, there you go. Kodi is loaded and fully functional. So from this point, you can follow the hundreds of different tutorials that they have for installing different Kodi add-ons like Exodus and the others. And I will post some links on how to do those. So at $39.99, this is gonna definitely be a tough deal to beat. I do think they have a winner here with the Fire TV Stick, considering that it's more powerful, it's capable as ever, and it's super cheap. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it for this video. If you like it, hit that thumbs up button for me. I wanna hear your comments. Go ahead and post in the comment section. I'll respond to your comments, and I'll see you guys in the next video.